Hello everyone, and welcome at the webinar of Vectar for the Creator course for the beginners. And this time the location is a little bit different than we've done the other times. I'm now improvising, and I've set up a studio at my home, as many others right now in the rest of the world, due to the COVID crisis. So I hope everyone is viewing this webinar in good health, and we are blessed that everyone in our company is still in good health, and our team is continuing forward in the same pace as we did before, but everyone is now working from their own place at home. So this is a unique setting, doing this webinar from my home. And still, it's the same content, of course, the same webinar we're providing. And our aim is to help you getting started with Vectar and to make the best augmented and virtual reality presentations possible, especially in these days. I think using AR and the fact that it's based on smartphones, we can help a lot of people learn new things in augmented reality and also have fun. I mean, get their mind of things, everything that's happening around them. So I'm really looking forward that every one of you is taking on Vectar and Vectar Studio and to create the best content possible. So let's get started. And we have participants, by the way, from Mexico, South Africa, and from the Netherlands. That's why this tutorial now is in English. Other times you also provide them in Dutch. But we'll get into that later on. So there is a chat possibility. If you have questions, you can use the chat and I'll try to answer as much as possible during this webinar. But if there are questions that need a more elaborate answering, I'll contact you later. So that's also possible. So again, let's get started. And the program for today, what we're going to do is I'm going to tell you about Vectar, the way that it's set up, how the app works, and the alignment with Vectar Studio. Then, of course, getting started. I'll show you how easy it is to set up your first augmented and virtual reality presentation. It literally takes less than 5 or 6 minutes. And I'll show you how it works. And if you get the basics, then it doesn't matter whether you place a 3D object or a video or an image or whatever. So that's about getting started. And I'll also point out where you can find all the other tutorials and the help that you can find at on the website, but also how to contact us if you have any questions. We're here to help you and make sure that you get make the best AR and VR presentations possible. And afterwards, the third part is becoming a professional. I'll also give you pointers for the best practice, what you have to take into account if you make an AR presentation or a VR presentation, how to make sure that your viewers get the best experience possible. And that's what we call becoming a professional. So let's continue. The first part about Vectar. We started Vectar now about 2 years ago, and we launched the platform in its current setting about 6 months ago. And from that point on, we've been growing rapidly. We have been developing now for 1.5 years, a so-called cross-platform. That means that we support both augmented and virtual reality. So when you get started with Vectar Studio, everything that you create is available on Apple smartphones and the iPad. It's available on Android devices, but also on the Oculus Go and the Oculus Quest. So you get both AR and VR, and that's quite unique. There are no other software around there that works that way. So that means that that's also multi-device. And the vision behind that is that you have a content that you want to provide to your audience, and it doesn't matter what type of device that they have. If you look now at a lot of people working from home, that means that if you have created all types of VR content, many people don't have a VR device at home. So that means that content you can't use right now for training. And then the smartphone comes in. On the other hand, VR also has a lot of benefits in contrast to AR. So you can do both. Multi-user, that's also an aspect we'll go into during this course. because there's a functionality within the Vector app that you can view the content simultaneously with several users, and you see each other moving around the content. And that's a very effective way of explaining a lot of things. And it works really well. Again, it works on a standard smartphone. Another part, we have spatial editing. Now, spatial editing, we'll go into that during this course. And the last thing will be created, it's no coding. So you don't have to be a programmer or whatever to work on the content. And that's also a big benefit. So you can start rapidly, you can create all types of content and interactions, and there's no coding whatsoever and no installation. Vector is a software as a service solution. So you don't need to install anything. You just can get started. So what do we mean by multi-device content distribution? These are great words to use for a marketeer. But the idea behind it is that whatever device, any place, anytime, you can view the content. And so if you look at augmented reality content, it's estimated that around 1.4 billion smartphones worldwide are now able to view augmented reality the way that we are using it in Vector. And then you may ask the question, okay, what about the other, like 1 billion, I think, is around that number. What about the other smartphones? Well, for those smartphones, we also have a solution. You can view it in 3D. So if you open up the Vector app, you see that the button has a pull-down menu, and you can switch between view in AR and view in 3D. And 3D means that you have a virtual room where you can view the content. And with that functionality, we can support like Android devices going back to Android version 3.4. So then you talk about smartphones that are about 11 to 12 years old. So then you have about 99% distribution possibility of your content. But the latest iPhones, let's say iPhones starting from 2017 and upwards, they're able to view the content in augmented reality. We have the sign up and the free trial account on the Vector Studio. You can go there through our website. And I assume that some of the viewers at this webinar have already set up an account. But you can also do this afterwards. It's automated. If you fill in your credentials, you'll get an invitation to join the free trial, and you can go ahead immediately. And you can create your first spaces. So what is Vector Studio? Vector Studio is a content management system for augmented and virtual reality. You create spaces. So every time you create a project, that's called a space. And within the space, you place spots. And these spots contain content. That's about the basics of Vector Studio. And there are also statistics in there that you'll be able to view how many viewers there are. And the statistics are also continued to grow at the moment. So we're expecting new dashboards in just some time, and we have more statistics. It's proven technology. We're now running towards like 20,000 users at the moment. It's cloud-based. It's based on Microsoft Azure, so that means it's a scalable platform. We can, if we have like 50 million users at the same time, that's no issue. Due to Microsoft Azure, that's not because we're very smart, that's because Microsoft Azure has the right platform that we use. Privacy by design, also very important for a lot of our customers. So we make sure that like if many schools use Vector, and then you have to be compliant for so many rules nowadays for privacy. So we set it up immediately. And also we use Microsoft Active Directory for the login. And that means that we also have possibilities for single sign-on, that you can see who uses the Vector Studio, and it's also with the single sign-on possibilities of Active Directory. So that's how far the introduction of Vector goes. If you want to read more about Vector, just go to the website. We're here today to create something. It's the webinar, create a course, of course. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch the screen, and I'm going to log on to Vector Studio. And we're going to set up a space. And in that space, I'm going to place a 3D object. If you have your smartphone ready, then you can use the QR code in the smartphone, in the Vector app, to view the actual space that I'm creating. So you can see everything real time taking place. So now I have to switch my screen. 1 second. And here we go. That's step one. And step two. So what you see here now, I'm logged on to Vector Studio. And with the browser, wait, then you see better that it's the browser that I'm working on. I'm logged on in the demo account of Vector. And when you start, you get an overview of all the spaces that are available. And these spaces, you can just create them and edit them and all the things you want to do with it. So now I'm going to create a new space. And when I start it up, enter the name of your new space. And this is the project name. So this is project webinar. This is the project name. And this is how the webinar of how the project is visible here in Vector Studio. And I'm not logged in the right demo account that I see. Let's do it again. Here we go. Yeah, this is the right one. Vector Airplane. So what I'm going to do now is create the project webinar. This is project name. So the title that you see here is only visible within Vector Studio. And it's not the title that you see in the Vector app. I click on, the Vector Airplane demo. Let me see. I've just missed something. Okay, well, it doesn't matter. I have here the project Vector Airplane. And within this project, I can now see the content that I've created before. And there's different types of content available. There's a 3D object. There's a holo presenter and there's a 360 image available at the moment. And that's the general here on top. Here's the marketing information. So if you have a title, this is the title that I want to show outside. So I'd say Vector Airplane. And here's the description. This is this description. It's also very important to make sure that everyone can find the content in the Vector app. So make sure that there's always a description available. Social share text, I'll get into this much later on. And but these things, you can also find them in the tutorial. So space saved. And there's another one, it's publish settings. Here you can set the setting how you want to make sure that the space is available. Again, these settings, you can find them in the tutorials and with the description, how to use these. Now let's go to general. So if I want to add a new content, so let's say, let's delete this one and delete the holo presenter. Let's clean it up a little. So that's how easy it works. So if I want to add new content, let's say GLTF, that's a type of 3D models where we're very fond of GLTF. It's a very augmented reality friendly format for smartphones. So I've just added the GLTF file and I have a small screen on the other hand. Here you see choose file. So let's say I want to find a 3D file. There's this marketplace called Sketchfab. And in Sketchfab, you have all different types of available content in 3D, and that's a really nice marketplace. And the nice thing also about Sketchfab is that it supports GLTF format. And due to the webinar, this is one of the disadvantages of doing a webinar from home, that sometimes the internet connection is not that fast. So let's say we go to the Vector. There's a small delay. Now, if you do a search in Sketchfab, then you see all different models that are available. And let's say, again, the Vector airplane. That's a model you can always use as a placeholder if you want to create a project and you want to try something. Just take out the Vector airplane, and you see downloading the model. And when you've set up a free account at Sketchfab, this is also something I always recommend. You can set up a free account, and when you have a free account, then you can download the 3D models that are for free, of course. So what I just do is press the download 3D model button. And then you see here the availability of the different types of 3D models. In this case, we take the auto-converted format GLTF. Press download, and it's downloading now the file. Here it is, 3.2 MB, and it downloads as a zip file. And I do nothing with the zip file, I just leave it as it is. I go back to Vector Studio. So here I have the GLTF spot that I created. I say choose file, and then I go to my downloads folder, and there is the airplane zip file. I say open, and then it's important when you upload a file, you just say the height. So take it to the height of the 3D model is the height of a 3D model from the pivot, so the center bottom of the 3D model, and then the height of this. And in this case, I'll just fill in 60 centimeters. It's in centimeters. And I'll change the name in airplane. Okay, save changes. So here you go. I've just created a space with an airplane and going to this part, the publish settings. And what you see here, is all the this is how you can view content with your smartphone or another device. So what you see here is that we use space codes. So in the Vector app, you can add a space code. We have share URLs, and these URLs, you can use them on your website and all different forms. And we have QR codes. And these QR codes, they're very nice to work with because you can just add them to a PowerPoint. You can add them to printed manuals. You can add them in all sorts of ways to existing material. So this way, when you have a course or something, you can just upgrade the course with augmented reality content. And every time you create a space, there's a unique QR code generated. And the way that these QR codes work and also these share URLs is that when someone clicks on this URL or zooms in on the QR code, you get, when you have the Vector app installed, it will open the Vector app and the content will be shown. If you don't have the Vector app installed yet, it will first pass you through to the App Store, whether it's the iOS or Apple App Store. And then you can download the app, the Vector app, and then you can view the content. So we've made it really easy to distribute your content. So all you need is the share link or the QR code to distribute your content. And within the app, there are also other possibilities. If you're in the Vector app itself, you can share content using social media. You can share the content on WhatsApp or Instagram, or all the other ways that are available on your smartphone. And again, this is also very powerful. Just imagine that you have someone, a service someone in the field, and he's doing some work on a machine, and he needs an additional manual or some support from outside, you can send this person a WhatsApp message. And in this WhatsApp message, there is this link that he can click on, and then he can view the content in 3D, in augmented reality. So again, we made it very easy to distribute your content. So this is actually the basics working with Vector Studio. So you can choose new content, all the different types of content that are available. It can be basic content, advanced image with 360 videos and 360 images, the Holo Presenter. I will get into the Holo Presenter also after this demo. Then different types of 3D models. And then what it's all about is interaction. And so it's nice to place a 3D model, but what's really nice with Vector is you can add interaction. And there are different types of interaction. Again, you can find these in the tutorials. Each of these interaction types are described and how you can use them. So you can use navigate, then you can go from one space to another space. So you can set up chapters and paragraphs, these kind of things. With hyperlinks, there are many other possibilities. Then you can also use an email hyperlink or call to hyperlink, or a hyperlink just going to the website or going to YouTube. That's with the hyperlink button. Here, the button itself, the button functionality, you can show and hide content. Works really nice. Anchoring, that's for the advanced users. In an advanced course of a Vector, we'll go into the anchoring. And questions. Adding questions is really easy. This is a widget functionality. You can add a question, you can add answers, and then you can have multiple trials and these kind of things. So the question button is also very easy. So we have all different types of content that you can add in AR and VR, and you can add all types of interactions with this content. So these are the basics of Vector Studio. So now that I've shown you how easy it is to set up a space with the project name and all the marketing information and add content, I'm going to pick up a few of the content parts, what we see as what we call killer content. So the killer content, that's about the 3D object and about the Holo Presenter. And so let's go into that a little further. The slides that I'm showing now are slides that you can find in the tutorials. And these describe the process that I've just shown in a live demo of Vector Studio. How to create a new space, the marketing information, where you find the exact title and the categories and the descriptions, why it's important. We also have a PowerPoint available on our website that will help you create a nice header or a thumbnail or these kind of things in the right format. So it's very easy to use PowerPoint and create your first page. You can add your logo in all sorts of ways. Use a PowerPoint and make it easier. The categories that you can choose and the publish settings. Here we describe how to use the QR code in the Vector app. When you press the search button underneath, then you see the option of the QR code. And you can scan the QR code and you can view the content. Then something about spatial editing. What I said in the introduction. What makes Vector also unique as a tool to create AR and VR is that we use spatial editing. And what do we mean by spatial editing? Well, when you start making a presentation, you have to take into account the position of your content in the space that you are creating. So you have the X, the Y, and the Z axis that you use in placing an object. And we see that a lot of people still, it's kind of difficult. When you're experienced as a user, it's easy. You can do it just in a few seconds. But for the starting user, he just want to make a better way of working with XYZ. In short, the X stands for left or right, and this is from the viewer point. So when the viewer places a space in front of him or her, then the X is the X over the left to right. The Y is for up and down, and the Z value is for front or back. And the center of each presentation is always 0, 0, 0. Oh, it's very important, because sometimes you have 3D objects that you can find somewhere and they have a different center. So be aware of that. But then we created spatial editing. Spatial editing means that when you log on to the Vector app using your account of Vector Studio, so when you open up the app, you have a menu at the right bottom side. When you open up the menu, you see account. And then with the account of Vector Studio, you can log on into the app. And then you have the button My Spaces. You click on the button My Spaces, and then you get an overview of the spaces that are available for you, where you have the right, those are your spaces you can edit. And when you open up the space, you see the edit button pointed out by the red arrow. And when you press the red the edit button, then what you see is that the your screen has changed. You see a grid on the floor, and each object that you select by tapping on it gets a white outline. And when the object or content gets a white outline, you can do all sorts of things with it. You can just hold your finger on the screen and walk around to move the object. So you walk towards a 3D object, you tap to select, it gets a white outline, then you place your finger on the screen and you can just move it around. You can just walk to a designated place, you say, okay, that's where I want to place it. But not just moving it around, you can also rotate the object, you can resize it by using pinching. And with two fingers, you can resize the object or the content. And all types of rotation are also possible. So you can also do rotations over the X, Y, and Z, Z axis. So that makes it really easy and really visible for creating your content. And that's what we call spatial editing. And so in the creation process, the way that it works, you start off creating a space in Vector Studio. You add the content in Vector Studio, and sometimes you already have a little bit in your mind that I want to place it a little bit to the left and this part to the right and this bit to the front and to the back. And when once you've done that, then you log on to the Vector app, and then you start with spatial editing, and you can place it exactly where you want to place it. And that is a very visual way, easy way of working. And working this way is also, again, it's no programming, there's no coding involved, and makes it really easy. So you get a lot of production done in very small time. If you go to the website from Vector, vector.com, you have support. And at support, there is also these tutorials available, the slides that you've just seen here before. But also getting started, that's a one pager that shows you in less than 5 steps how you can work with it and how to get started. So I've talked about setting up the content. I've talked about placing the content. I've talked about the spatial editing and refining it. So let's zoom in on a few content types that we always say that's our killer content. And how does that work if you want to add the different types of content that are available? Again, I was talking about the 3D models, the images, and but let's zoom in on the Holo Presenter. The Holo Presenter is really killer content. It's really easy to produce because you make an holographic presenter just using your smartphone. All you need is a green screen and someone's going to stand in front of the green screen. You film it with your smartphone, and the raw footage, you upload it in Vector Studio. So you don't need to do any video editing whatsoever. If you open up the Vector app, and within the app, you can see several examples of the usage of a holographic person. And this always works very well, because in our vision, we always say people communicate with people. It's a very powerful way of demonstrating products, of giving instructions, making a manual more immersive, and all the possibilities that are there. So all you need to do is film someone standing in front of a green screen, upload it, and we made it really easy for you to do some settings. And all you do is you just, with the color picker, once the you've uploaded the video, the video is shown in a still image in Vector Studio, then you can choose the right color, the green color, because every time that you shoot a green screen movie, take into account that every time the green color is different. There's a different lighting, there's different clothes on a person or whatever. So there's not one setting for a green screen. So every time that you upload a movie, set the background color. But that's one click at the background, and then you get the background color. The chroma cutoff, that's a technical term for the color range. So if you have selected a green color, the cutoff is how much green do you want to remove? That's what we mean by the cutoff. That's the range from plus to minus 0.415 or 0.25. And that's also something that you just, it needs some tweaking. You just try and error and see what is the best setting for the chroma cutoff. If it's too low, then everyone gets a green halo around the person. That's not really nice to see. And when the chroma cutoff is too high, then all the detail is gone. If, for instance, someone has very curly hair, then all these curls are gone. Then it's all flattened. So every time you upload a holographic presenter, just tweak a little with the background color and the chroma cutoff to get the best results. The length of this person, here it says the presenter height, right? About how tall is the presenter? You just fill it in centimeters. Positioning the head and the feet in a movie, that is done by a bar. When you work in Vector Studio, you've uploaded the video, then you see a bar at the bottom and a bar at the top, and you can just shift them around and to enter the right values for this person. So the height of the person, of the length, the position of the head and the position of the feet, and you're done. That's how you create a holo presenter. And one of our trade secrets, what we do with the holo presenter to get an idea, people think it's a 3D person, but it isn't. It's a 2D movie. But what we've done, we make it camera facing. So when there's a holographic presenter in a space telling his or her story, and the viewer walks around using a smartphone, this video is camera facing. So it's like this person is always facing you and telling you something. And that works really well. And that's how people get the idea that it's an actual 3D person standing there in this area, while it is a 2D movie. And again, you can just film it with your smartphone. And this is also from production cost point of view, it's really easy. In the tutorial, we've added a checklist. How you set up your studio. You can run it very basically just using only a green screen and your smartphone. If you want to go a step further, just make sure you have a tripod, a nice tripod where you set up your camera. Some lightings, you can buy these on Alibaba, whatever. The more light, the better it always is. That's with any video that you shoot. So here are some more tips and a checklist that you can use. You can set up your green screen studio for less than $100, you're up and running. So use it, because we say the HoloPresenter is our killer content. It makes it so much better, any 3D presentation. If you place an object of a machine or an engine and you want to do a demonstration or tell something about it, use the HoloPresenter. It makes it, your message much more powerful. So to continue, we also have the 3D models. And let's get into that a bit more, because 3D models, the thing with 3D is that these are, this is work in progress, not just for us, but for the entire world. 3D is very under development at the moment. There are about 50 different software out there in the world that are used to create 3D models. You have like the Maya and the AutoCAD and SketchUp, to name a few. And these different software also have a different way of creating 3D models. And so you get about 50 different 3D types out there in the world. And these formats also have their own extensions and possibilities. So they're like literally thousands of different 3D models out there. And that makes it rather difficult to work with. That's why we favor GLTF. The GLTF format has been coming up now in about these last 12 months. And it's like MP3 for music or MP4 for video. You now see that GLTF is making a good chance of becoming a standard for 3D models, especially for augmented reality and virtual reality. So when you have your own 3D models, and you have people creating these models for you, the 3D modelers, so to speak, ask them about the possibilities to export a 3D model to GLTF. Once you have your model in GLTF, you can do anything with it that you want to. You see that large, big companies like Airbus or there are many big companies in the US, they're now all exporting their entire libraries with 3D models into GLTF. Not just IKEA, but all the others as well. So that's a good standard to work with. But we have the OBJ possibility. And for the advanced user, we have Unity 3D. And the advanced users, when they use Unity, then everything is possible. Then you can create the most immersive content that's available out there. Then you can create entire game-like content in Vector using our distribution platform and everything that comes with it. We have a lot of support and help there. You can contact our service desk. We'll help everyone getting started with Unity. You just need a few pointers how to start off with Unity. And if you take those into account and you set up the asset bundles as described, you can just import these into Vector, an Android version and an iOS version, and you're up and running. And for performance, it's also very nice to work with Unity 3D. But again, this is for the real advanced users, and we can help them out. So this is, if you want to have like game-like stuff in Vector, that's Unity 3D. So I mentioned a lot about the GLTF format already, but please take into account when you use models also on the Sketchfab, you download these from Sketchfab, take into account that we favor a file size of maximum of 25 megabytes. There are two things there that are important. One, the Vector app is using online content. So that means every time that you view content, you have to download the content. And depending on the connection that a smartphone has, that's how much time it takes to view the content. And what you see is that an average user, if they have to wait 6 seconds to see content, there's a chance that they walk away. So that's the 25 MB. And also, if you have if you have an average, cheaper smartphone, sometimes it's also taken into account to keep the file size small. So for their memory usage, we also advise is 25 MBs. And then there's a technical term, it's called vertices. That's how many lines and angles there are within a 3D model. This is also depending on the model and how you use it, but we also say, well let's keep it underneath 400,000 vertices. And if you take that into account and you start looking at models on, for instance, like Sketchfab or the other available 3D models, then you can do anything that you want to with it. So that's something that you take into account. Well, then, also something that I think it's a very easy button to use, but very underestimated within the Vector, and it's the hyperlink. And you can add a button. So why is this hyperlink so important from my point of view? For instance, YouTube movies. I'll go into the best practices of creating an AR VR space in a few seconds. But the thing is, doing AR on a smartphone means that you're holding up a smartphone in front of you. And that's nice for immersive content and to see a lot of things. But we always say, well, this should not take longer than, let's say, 7 to 14 minutes per space. Because if you have to hold up your smartphone in front of you to view a YouTube movie of 20 minutes or so, yeah, that's not very nice for the viewers. So then it's better to place a short movie in your AR space or VR space, and then add an hyperlink to YouTube. So when they press the YouTube link, then the on your smartphone, YouTube opens up, and then you can see the rest of the movie, and you can switch back to Vector when you're done with the YouTube movie. And that goes for other documents as well. So if you can add PDF documents this way, so that you show something in AR, and you say, if you want to read more about it, press here. They can go to a website, they can do to a PDF form, or a form. You can a questionnaire, for instance, that you start asking questions, or something else is that if you see you can do a product demonstration, and you can also add a buy now button. So that's with hyperlinks. That also makes it yeah, a lot of possibilities there with these hyperlinks. So that's how far. This is our few examples of how you can work with all the spaces. And again, in the Vector app itself, there are now like 150 different demonstrations available of what you can do with the app. All the content that you see in the Vector app was made with Vector Studio. So each time you see something and you think, hey, this looks nice, you can contact us and ask questions about it. So I saw this space and you've done this and this. How can I do this? And we're really, if we can help you, we love to do that. So let's get into the best practice. We're now at the final part of the webinar. And I want to give you a few pointers if you get started creating augmented reality. First, when you create a space, always take into account how big is the floor for your viewers. Because we can create any space, any size. Well, it depends on your smartphone, but we can create world-size spaces that can go up to 10 by 10 by 3 meters big. To give an example, we've done a space journey for children at the primary school, and they can do the space journey outside, and they're walking from planet to planet. And when they see a planet, they can tap on it, they get all sorts of information. And that's a space journey. But the size of this space is 10 by 10 meters big. So that's world size. Room size, 3 by 3 meters. That's when you have enough room, then you can walk around to do things. But also you have the tabletop size is also something to take into account. We see with business users, many times they are viewing the content in their office, and you don't have, sometimes these offices aren't really big, or they have a big table in front of them, then they can use tabletop size. There's also something there that when you want to see a space, you can also use pinching to resize the space. So every space that is available in the Vector app, you're able to resize the space using pinching. And that's when you see the ghosted view of each space, the grayed out view. When you see that, then you can use pinching to resize the space. So then also the big space, even the wall side spaces, you can make them as small so that they can fit on the table. The second point, don't put too many different content in one space. Keep the focus on your core message. But that's something that you have to take into account for any presentation. Even this webinar, I'm throwing a lot of information your way. So there's it would have been better maybe if I haven't put too many content in one presentation, and that also accounts for augmented reality and virtual reality. If you use text in a space, it's better with a solid or transparent background. Floating text is sometimes very hard to read on a smartphone. So look at that, how you can use that. Then the fourth point, to move is to remember. That one is really important. The more a viewer moves, the better he or she remembers the presentation. That has to do with the way the memory works in a so-called contextual memory. We'll go into that in an advanced course. But if you place an object in 3D, a 3D object, turn it away about 30 degrees away from the viewer. So when he moves his smartphone, he gets an idea, hey, wait a minute, this is 3D, and he starts moving. And as soon as he starts moving, make sure there's something behind the object as well. So he has a flow and he starts moving, because to move is to remember. That's really best practice in AR and VR. And take the possible context into account so that you know where people are looking at the content. Is it at home? Is it in the business? Is it in a factory? Is it in an airport? Take that also into account. And last one, use audio for the voiceover and background noise. That's also to get a more realistic experience. We also say use the audio, and it gets more immersive. So these are the best practices. And last but not least in this Create a Course webinar, when you've created your first space, check out collaboration tool in the Vector app, because you can create a Vector, you can in Vector app, you can create a session, you can give that a name, you can choose whether or not it gets a password, and other people from all around the world, they can join your session. All they need is the name of the session and a password, whether or not if you added it, and then you can work together in augmented reality. And that's something we are going to show it more, because this is also a killer feature in the Vector app. So now I've come to the end of this webinar. This was the Create a Course webinar of Vector for beginners. There will be an advanced course available also in a webinar form. You can also look at it, but that's for people that already have used Vector Studio and are already familiar with the different types of content. And then we go into these best practices and how you can become a real AR professional and expert. This presentation that you have seen now is available on the Vector website. You can go to support, and there you see tutorials, and then you see all the slides that you've seen now are available there, and you can use them. This week, we are going to publish the video tutorials as well. There will be available in English and in a Dutch language. So we have Dutch video tutorials available as well. The things that I've shown now, the demonstration, are all available then on the Vector channel on YouTube and through the website of Vector. And that makes it really easy to get started with Vector Studio and create the best AR and VR that's out there. So that's part of our mission, to make sure that everyone to make the AR and VR dream come true. That's the mission of Vector. I truly hope that all of you today that have were here at the webinar will create these presentations, not just because you'll be able to help people learn something new and to see new things, but also to get their mind of things in these times that are now out there with the COVID crisis going on. It's our mission also today. We want to create as many content as possible. We've published an escape room last week, a free escape room. Just try it out, and then you also see what's possible in AR. And there's more to come. We have the planking experience and more. Just also, to get the mind of things with everything that's going on. So I really hope that everyone is staying healthy this next few weeks. I hope you enjoyed this webinar. Please feel free to give some comments on the email or to the website for improvements, because everything can always improve. And we're looking forward to seeing your creations. And again, if you need any help, contact our help desk. We're happy to help you. Also with the 3D models, you can send them through. We can look at it. We can say this is the best way to export them from a certain type of software. And once they get, if you know how it's done, then you can export anything that you want to from that software. And we are happy to help you out. So again, thank you for joining this webinar. And I hope to see your creations and stay healthy. Thank you very much.